So let us come to the different relationships between the price and demand. Different relationship. So should the blue curve be a straight downward sloping line, or should it be a non-linear downward sloping, right? A downward sloping curve. How should the relationship be, right? That should also matter. The simplest possible example is a linear demand response curve, right? So demand response curve. So demand at a particular price point P may have some initial value D0. Slope is given by M and P is the price. So what is the demand at a particular price? So this is the price, and D0 minus M into P will be the demand at that particular price. This D0 is called the demand at price 0. When P is 0, what is the demand? Demand is D0. So this is the demand at price equal to 0. This can also be called as the market size, because look at the interpretation. Price is 0. You are offering the product for free. So when you are offering the product for free, how many people actually demand this product will really tell you what is the market size. What is the complete market size? What is the total market size? Right? Because you really can't do anything better. You are offering the product for free. Right? The demand at that particular price point, which is actually 0, you can't reduce anything lesser than that. Anything lesser than that actually means that you are actually giving money to the consumers to use your product. Right. So, as we said, we are not going to consider that case. We are going to look at only non-negative values. So, price equal to 0 is really the minimum price. At that price, what is the demand? That is called the market size. That is called the market size, and M is called the slope. So, mathematically, what is D0? D0 will be the y-intercept. We are talking about a linear response curve. So, we are going to draw a straight line. Let me change the color. So, let us say that this is the demand response curve. As I said earlier, what is on the x, always remember, what is on the x-axis? X-axis is always the price, and y-axis is always the demand. Demand responds to a particular price. This guy here is D0. This guy here is D0 because the price is 0. At price equal to 0, what is the total market size? To be precisely correct, I should not have drawn this portion, right? I should simply start here and end here, because as I said, non-negative region. So I should not extend it to the negative region. I should not extend it below the x-axis, right? So this is called D0. This is called the market size. Now the price at which demand is equal to 0 is called satiating price. Right. Let us represent that by a new color. This price is called satiating price. Satiating price means the market is satiated. That's it. If you increase the price beyond PS, demand is expected to be 0. Right. This is really the highest price that you can charge. So that price is given by, when the demand is equal to 0, so set this equal to 0, and you are going to get the satiating price as D0 divided by M. So that is called the satiating price. So we have looked at the Y intercept, which is the market size. We have looked at the x-intercept, which is called the satiating price. The elasticity of this curve is given by this expression, and you can verify from the definition of elasticity that this really is the elasticity of this curve. What is important to notice is this expression you can derive using the definition that we had a couple of slides ago. What you should be more attentive towards is to realize that this elasticity depends on the price, which means that the elasticity does not remain constant in this region. Okay, does not remain constant in this region. Elasticity keep changing. How does it change? When price is 0, the elasticity is 0. Price is 0, elasticity is 0. Whereas, when the price approaches PS, really can't charge more than PS because at PS the demand becomes 0. What is the point of charging more than PS? Right? The demand has already become 0. So, as the price approaches PS, the elasticity goes to infinity. So, so elasticity can be as low as 0, it can be as high as infinity when the price is approaching PS, when the price is approaching PS. So, for a linear response curve, elasticity is not constant, elasticity can keep changing, elasticity can keep changing. All right? Take a moment to digest, right? So, this is a linear demand response curve, linear demand response curve, and therefore, it is a straight line, downward sloping, positive, continuous and differentiable, right? And these are the interpretations, interpretation of market size, interpretation of satiating price, and the elasticity interpretation. Now, the relationship between price and demand need not always be linear, it may be non-linear, right. So, there is another curve called constant elasticity curve, So, here we saw the elasticity keeps changing from 0 to infinity. Right. What if we want to keep the elasticity constant? That curve is given by this expression. This expression, demand is equal to C into P to the power of negative epsilon. Epsilon is the elasticity. Okay. C is a constant. C is a demand when price is equal to 1. Right. C is a demand when price is equal to 1. This non-linear relationship will represent, this non-linear relationship will represent a curve where the elasticity does not change. Elasticity is constant at a particular value of epsilon. Now, you fix up the value of epsilon and the curve will change. So, essentially this is your price, x axis is always the price, y axis is always the demand, and there may be a non-linear relationship. Once again, downward sloping, non-negative, continuous and differentiable, but the shape of the curve is non-linear this time. What is the property? The property is we want to keep the elasticity constant, Now, you cannot guarantee that the demand may be either finite or the demand even may be satiated, the market may be satiated, right? Because you realize that as P approaches 0, as you reduce the price, if you reduce the price, the demand keeps spiking, demand keeps growing, right? So, demand may even approach infinity as the prices are reducing, right? So, you cannot say that demand is finite because demand may spike up, right? Demand may spike up as you are closing towards 0 from the right. And you realize that the demand may never touch the x-axis. The demand may never touch the x-axis, right? It may be asymptotic. It may be asymptotic on the x-axis. So for any value of p, the demand may not even become zero, right? There is always some demand. There is always some customer who is trying to buy the product at a price that you may offer, right? So, we cannot guarantee that demand may be finite, we cannot guarantee that demand curve will ever hit the x-axis, can't guarantee, right. Revenue for the previous curve also, for this curve also, revenue is always given by price multiplied by the demand. So, the total demand for the product multiplied by the price charged for each product will tell you the revenue. For the constant elasticity curve, the revenue will be C into P into C into P to the power of 1 minus epsilon. Right. As I said earlier, the price may be optimized, for maximizing the revenue, in that case, you will maximize this curve and then find P star, or we may maximize profit and therefore, get an optimal value of price. So, if we are maximizing revenue, this is the function that we are trying to maximize, right? Revenue is simply price multiplied by the demand. You can do the same thing even for the constant, even for the linear demand response curve. Okay, I hope things are clear so far. So, let us move ahead. But before we move ahead, essentially, if the elasticity is less than 1, what does it mean? It means that it is a product like salt. It is a product like salt where the product is actually quite inelastic, which means that the demand does not change even if the prices fluctuate. As I said, we need salt, that is it, we need salt, can't do without salt. So, in that case, there is always a way to increase revenue simply by increasing the prices, right? Because revenues are prices multiplied by the demand. Even if you increase the price, the demand is not going to change much, and therefore revenues can be increased simply by increasing the prices. However, if we are dealing with a product which is highly elastic, which means that the elasticity is more than 1, right? Elasticity is more than 1. Then revenue probably can be increased by setting up very, very low prices, right? Setting up very, very low prices, and therefore essentially mass selling. Therefore, we sell a lot and therefore generate more revenue. Price of each unit may be quite small, but that is compensated by huge demand, because we saw the curve as the prices are lesser, the demand may be shooting upwards, and that is how there is a mechanism to increase the revenue. There may be other mechanisms to get more profit, but right now we are talking about increasing the revenue because we saw the revenue function. All right. So, the strategies available for inelastic product may be different from the strategies available for a highly elastic product, right? Highly elastic demand. Okay, let us pause here for a moment. And recap what we have done. So, we have looked at what is called as a demand response curve. Demand response curve is a relationship between price and demand. We have seen 4 important properties. It is usually downward sloping, except for few goods. Luxury goods are a good example where the downward sloping may get violated. Always non-negative, considering the case that we are offering 0 as the minimum price. And it has nice properties that it is continuous and differentiable, right? We need continuity, we need differentiability, because we should be able to take derivative, because we want to maximize revenue, we may want to maximize profit. Therefore, finding optimal prices, we may need these properties of continuity and differentiability. So, these are the 4 nice properties of a demand response curve. Right, demand sensitivity is measured using slope, which is just change in demand to change in prices. Slope is generally negative, right? Or we can measure price sensitivity using what is called as elasticity. Elasticity is percentage change in demand to percentage change in price, the ratio of these two. Usually a unitless quantity, right? A different interpretation from slope. And one important property of elasticity is it may have a time axis. The elasticity value in short term may be different than the elasticity value in the long term. Different relationship types between price and demand. We can think of a very simple linear relationship between price and demand. So, D0 minus M into P, where M is the slope, D0 is the y-intercept. Y-intercept is also called the market size. That is the demand when price is 0. When the demand is 0, that price is called satiating price. Elasticity of a linear demand response curve actually is not constant. It keeps changing. It may be as low as 0. It may be very close to infinity when the prices are fairly close to the satiating price. So, that is a very simple linear demand response curve. We can think about a non-linear response curve. For example, we can think about a curve where the elasticity remains constant, and that curve is given by demand is equal to C into P to the power of negative epsilon, where epsilon is the elasticity. C is a constant because it represents demand when price is equal to 1. in such a curve, the basic properties are not still violated. It is still a non-negative curve. It is still a downward sloping curve. It has continuity. It is differentiable. So all those properties hold. But in this kind of a curve, we cannot guarantee that the demand may be finite. We cannot guarantee that the demand is always satiated, right? The revenue is simply price multiplied by demand. If we are dealing with a product which is which is very inelastic, there is a scope to increase revenue by simply increasing price. If we are dealing with a very, very elastic product, the revenue can be increased by reducing the price, setting the price fairly close to zero. So let us end the session here. Let us end this session here. And we will continue with this. As I said, the objective of this topic is to be able to estimate this demand response curve, but we will come to that in the next session. So let us pause and come back for the next session of this later.